why I miss Lainey's ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, good. Ready for a great night tonight. Great to be here. I want to acknowledge our ancestors from this country, the traditional owners on the Gadigal country and the Eora nations. Thank you for having us. And it's great to be at the Puri Gua 2017. Great to see everyone here, eh? 101, 107, eh? Yeah, well, my name's Shirley Hood. Yeah, I've come from a big family. I'm Newmark United British Kamara. I've got 6 brothers and 5 sisters. Big Hood family, eh? It's funny, not one of us are named Robin, you know? Yeah. Well, as you see, I've joined the I family lately, as if my family ain't big enough, eh? But I joined the I family, and I've got an iPhone and an iMac, yeah. And I walk around with condoms called iFuck. Yeah, I'm looking for my man and my apartment, man. Exactly, you know. But it's all about, like, looking and feeling good, you know. Because I tell you, I'm a real cunt. I'm a real country song, mate. I'm a real country song, eh? Because I've got nothing. I've got no man, no money, no home, no dog, and no teeth. And before anybody asks, no, I'm not going to bite you, yes. You know, but it was crazy, you know, how my teeth got knocked out. I was freaking, you know. Yeah, I was hanging with my niece and nephew, you know, in the backyard. Get it right, eh? Mm. You know, I was hanging with my niece and nephew in the backyard, and I had my baby nephew on my hip, spinning my niece on the clothesline, eh? Woo! And we were laughing, you know? Next minute, the big wet towel come out of nowhere. Knocked my teeth straight out, man. Next minute, I was crying, eh? Quick, everyone, look for my teeth, you know? I was freaking out and I didn't know what to do, eh? I didn't know what to fucking do. So I decided I'd stay with family a bit longer. Hey, you know how family fits you up, eh? Hey, you toothless bitch. Yeah, pass the pepper, toothy. Hey, I was gonna knock your teeth out, but I forgot they already gone. Yeah, hey, you know? And so in the end, I had to come back to work and all that, you know, so I had to go to the only person to tell me the truth straight out, my mum, aye. So I went to my mum and I'm like, hey mum, come on, does it look okay? Tell me the truth, mum, just tell me the truth. She reckoned, hey, Dorts, can you handle the truth? Can you handle that truth? Yeah, I said, yeah, look at that, come on, mum, I can handle the truth. She went, get you a bloody dentist. Yeah, dentist, eh? 2:30. You know, so I go to a bloody dentist, you know. Like when he got his mouth, you know, his hands in my mouth going for it. Got the nurse with the suction pipe, she going for it. You know, it's like a fucking party in my mouth, mate. And I wasn't invited, man. You know, but it's all about looking and feeling good, eh? That's all we want. We want to look and feel good, you know. So I was going to the beauty shop, right? So I went to the beauty shop, and when I walked in, I saw on the window, front window, tanning special. Being the person I am, I walked straight in there. Hey, I'm here for my tanning special. You know, I said, yeah, hey ladies, yep, come in. We're in the beauty shop at the moment. Yeah, you know, come in for my tan special, you know. And I said, yeah, well, I came in last year, eh, and I got the Aboriginal, right? Yeah. Exactly, boom. But it's really hard living as an Aboriginal in this country, you know? So I thought this year I'd get the Jamaican, man. Yeah, man. Nah, not really, I'm here for the Brazilian. Exactly, eh. And I at least recommend to all you ladies, eh? You at least have to try a Brazilian once in your life. You know, at least once in your life. Try a Brazilian, because they got big cocks and they know how to use them. Fuck yeah! that one, Regina? You like that one? Yeah, you know? But that's what it's about, you know? And sometimes hard to be, you know? Sometimes hard to be Aboriginal person in this country, you know? There's lots of different things we could do, and then also something we could do, you know? But we had to fight to be able to do these things, eh? Like 50 years ago, you wouldn't imagine black fella here with a microphone, eh? Yeah, you fellas, eh? We would have told it straight, eh? You know, because people have been carrying on, eh? Or hear people carrying on, you know? Those bait people. We're sick of those bait people. I'm like, what? You trying to tell me sick of those bait people? We've been sick of those bait people for over 250 years, man. So I'll break it down for you. Hey? Yeah. Poly, meaning many. Ticks, blood-sucking mongrels. Yeah. Exactly. I told you we should have built that Abbott-proof fence, man. Hey. I know that bastard keeps coming in, you know. Oh, my God. You know, and he's bad because, like, he is Minister for Women of Minister for Women Affairs, he was Minister for Indigenous Affairs. If he was Minister for Left-Handed Affairs, I would have just killed myself on the spot. Hey, because, you know, having a man, the Minister for Women Affairs, is as crazy as having, like, a white fella as a Minister for Aboriginal Affairs, eh? You know? And I always say, that's what I say, woman, heck, why aren't gay and lesbian and transgender people allowed to get married? Yeah. Man? Yeah. Hey, boom! They tried to stop us black fellas from getting married, eh? Yeah. You know, they tried legally for many years, but we fucking fought it. You know? Never stopped us breeding, but eh? And we're fucking good at that, you know, we're good breeders, man. That's why it's like, be careful, white fellas, don't take 2.5 children, you know? We got at least 6 or 12 or something, family, mate. Yeah, you know? And it is funny, but that's what I was saying. We all should be allowed to get married in this country, eh? You know? Good. Because we all have the equal right, man. The equal right to suffer together. You know, same-sex marriage being an abomination, you know? But then, you know, abomination. Have they seen the TV shows fucking Bachelor and Married at First Sight? They're fucking abominations, you know? Yeah. You know? So come on, please, eh? This year is about equality, eh? You know, and we have got our equal rights. And it's about loving and sharing together, you know? And it is. I mean, I'm hetero, you know? Nothing wrong with that, eh? But fucking hell, I love that you as a family, as bloomin', just let all the love out here, and I can feel it. So for this 2 weeks, man, I'm fucking gay ass.
Make some noise for Shirley.